If you've ever wanted to have the same user information of your Azure AD or Entra ID in your GLPI and also use the same user and password from your Microsoft 365, stay tuned because we have two new plugins that you can use to do that. My name is Artur Schaefer and welcome back to another video of TechLib YouTube channel. Usually, when you have massive information or massive users to provision on your GLPI and they come from Entra ID, which is the old Azure ID, you have to create it manually or access it manually because you need it to be inserted in your GLPI. And you don't need to do it anymore. Because right now, we have the SCIM protocol, which is a global protocol to provision users from one side to the other, and not just user and password, but also to provision information like telephone number, contact information, managers. And you can do this in just a couple of clicks. As you can see here, we have a little mock-up on how this works. So for example, we have here Microsoft Azure Active Directory, which right now is named Entra ID, I believe. But you can change it or replace it by Okta, for example, where you can also put information like name, email, address, contact information, and all this is posted to other services that you use, including GLPI. So for example, if you want to have the name, email, UPN, address, office name, department, and manager of your Microsoft Azure or Entra ID on your GLPI instance, you just need to use one plugin called SCIM, or SCIM for some. And to use your user and password for Microsoft 365, you can just install the plugin Oauth SSO and make it work. So you have all the information from your Azure ID or Entra ID in your GLPI, and you can also use the same user and password without the need of additional passwords to your user, and I'm going to show you right now. So here we have an instance of GLPI on our network cloud, and you can just install the plugins called SCIM. Click on Discover and then type SCIM, install it, and also the Oauth SSO. The configuration steps are going to be on the description below and also on our blog post regarding this same video. Right now, we are going to take a look at the users that we have created in our Entra ID. For example, here I have the Arthur, AS, DS, and JC. If you see on our GLPI instance, we have just one user, which is the AS, Arthur Schaefer, on Microsoft.com. And we are going to add the both of the other users in here and also try to access this using one of these Microsoft Entra IDs. So on our Microsoft Azure, we are going to hit Microsoft Entra ID. So we are going to just hit the Enterprise Applications to see our SCIM application that we have previously created. So we click on that and we are going to choose which users and groups are going to be provisioned. So let's imagine that remember that this is a test container, so we are not able to select a role, so we are going to just select the users. And in this case, I'm just hitting DS and JC, which are the two new that we want in our GLPI instance. We're going to hit select and click assign. So from now on, all of these users are going to be created or updated or on our GLPI instance automatically. And you have to just choose which way of this provisioning is going to be selected, which is like automatic in this situation, and which information are going to be stored there. But to make it quickly, we are going to provision the two users on demand. So JC, we're going to provision, hit validating, and probably everything is going to be green. Everything is green. All the information is here. And we are going to also provision another one, which is the DS Azure. Provision, validating, and it's probably there. Yeah. Let's come back to our GLPI instance, which is here. Hit refresh and see. Yeah, we have the DS and also the JC. I have already resetted the password of this DS. So right now I know this information and I'm opening a new tab, private tab, and I'm just clicking on Azure and DS at Arturship. Let me just copy it because it's quicker. Good, right now it's okay. Here's the password. So it's just asking me to create a new password. So let's create a new password and see if it agrees with my new password. Sign in. It will probably ask me to create a two-step verification, but I'm just hitting to ask later because it's just a test one. Stay signed in. And right now we have access to our GLPI instance using my Microsoft 365 ID. If you want to configure it, make sure that you have your GLPI publicly to the internet because Azure needs to access your GLPI to send information, to update information. So for example here, let me show you the information being configured. So here we don't have phone numbers. Good. And we are coming back here, clicking on users, going to DS Azure, and adding properties like telephone number. And I'm just creating a number, which is 999, and save. And again, I'm going to provision it on demand, provision on demand, to make it quickly. DS, click, provision, validating. And right now, probably we are going to see a new phone number after we refresh. So here's a phone number. Great, isn't it? And remember, you always can watch for the logs here on SCIM identity servers. You can just hit here and see which information is being sent to your GLPI instance. So it's not the other way around. It's, remember, we have here the Microsoft Azure AD being sent to these services, including GLPI. So it's not the other way around. It's the Microsoft Azure that sends it to GLPI.